109 in your blue book. I give you thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, as you declare all your wondrous deeds to the prayers of the power of God, our Savior, save us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen. To the prayers of the power of God,
from the epistle of St. Paul to the Galatians.
Let us get
them there. Brethren, I assure you the gospel I proclaim to you is no mere human invention. I did not receive it from any man, nor was I schooled in it. It came by revelation from Jesus Christ. You have heard, I know, the story of my former way of life in Judaism. You know that I went to extremes in persecuting the Church of God and tried to destroy it. I made progress in Jewish observance far beyond most of my contemporaries. In my excessive zeal to live out all the traditions of my ancestors. But the time came when he who had set me apart before I was born and called me by his favor chose to reveal his son to me that I may spread among the Gentiles the good tidings concerning him. Immediately, without seeking human advisors, or even going to Jerusalem to see those who were apostles before me, I went off to Arabia. Later, I returned to Damascus. 3 years after that, I went up to Jerusalem to get to know Cephas, with whom I stayed 15 days. I did not meet any other apostles except James, the brother of the Lord.
Oh.
Christ as our Redeemer, and God's new Israel, his new chosen people. Today, Christ's birth is as valuable for us as he is our Redeemer, so that we may live in his kingdom forever. That is why we are to relive, not just reenact, Christ's life in the present, as if we are there. We are saved through Christ, and he keeps us safe from the danger of evil, as the angel kept him safe from Herod's wrath. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Christ is born. Thank you.
all through